Think about it. Where we would be. think it's Revelation 13:8, somewhere along there. The Bible talks about the Lamb, Jesus, that is slain before the foundation of the world. In God's mind, God's thinking, He had a plan for you and I way before the world was even formed. Way before the world was even formed, it was already a done deal that Jesus would go to the cross, that He would suffer and die. And when He did, He made it available for everyone to become the sons and daughters of the only true and living God. Just think of that. He loved us so much that He sent His Son to not only die, but to suffer and suffer and suffer and die on the cross and to be raised from the grave on the third day. He did all that because of His mercy, His kindness, His grace. And if you haven't made Him Lord, if you haven't made Him Lord of your life, what better time than right now to make Him Lord? Right where you're standing, right where you're sitting, would you just pray, if you haven't made Him Lord, and just say, Jesus, I confess to You. I confess to You that I'm a born sinner. I was born that way. I have a sin nature that I inherited from my father and his father all the way down to Adam. I have a sin nature, and I can't earn my way to heaven no matter how many noble and good deeds that I do. But I confess to You right now, Jesus, that I'm a sinner with no way out except You. And I thank You, Jesus, for dying on the cross for me. Right now, the best I know how, I reach out and I accept Your free gift of salvation. And I thank You for it, God. If you pray that simple prayer, and you mean it from the bottom of your heart, you are instantly a new creation. The Bible says that you are a new creation. You are God's child. You're God's child.
Hallelujah.
You're God's child. Your next step is you need to make it known. Don't ever be ashamed of God.
That's right.
So if you prayed that prayer and made Him Lord of your life, before you leave here today, let one of us know. You're in for a new day, a new life. We thank You, God. We thank You, God, that You provided a way. We thank You for the finished and complete work of Jesus on the cross and crucified and resurrected. That's the good news. Thank You, God. Right now, let's just take this opportunity to just thank Him. Do you remember where you came from?
Mercy, I don't.
grace is simply His divine assistance to accomplish life. Because we need His assistance in everything that we do.